Water. It's been around for billions of years. The water we use today is the same water that was on the Earth 4 billion years ago. We won't ever have more water than what is currently on the Earth and in the atmosphere. Water is a finite resource, and we all must work together to take care of it. We depend upon water to sustain us, keep us healthy, provide recreation, and help our economy. All living things need water. But after we use the water we need, what happens then? That's where Fairfax County's wastewater management comes in. Wastewater management is part of Fairfax County's Department of Public Works and Environmental Services, and it operates one of the largest sanitary sewer systems in the nation. Wastewater treatment removes most of the pollutants from the water we have used, and clean water is returned to the Chesapeake Bay.
The Noma Coal Pollution Control Plant receives and treats raw sewage 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, from the homes and businesses in the southern half of Fairfax County. The over 40 million gallons of raw sewage that the plant receives each day is enough to fill 63 Olympic-sized swimming pools.
So, what exactly is wastewater? Before we explore this, let's clarify the difference between wastewater and stormwater. Stormwater is precipitation from rain or snow. Stormwater that does not soak into the ground becomes runoff, which either flows into surface waterways or is channeled into storm sewers. This is why the overuse of pesticides and dangerous chemicals is discouraged. These can drain into storm sewers, compromising the health of our streams and rivers. More than 85% of households and almost all businesses within Fairfax County are connected to the sewer system. The resulting wastewater goes through a network of pipes, which, if stretched from end to end, would cover the entire width of the United States, a total of more than 3,000 miles. Depending on where you live in the county, your wastewater would go to either the Noman M. Coal Pollution Control Plant, which serves the green area on this map, or it would travel to treatment plants in the surrounding region. Here's what happens at the Noman M. Coal Plant. Raw sewage enters the plant from underground pipes from homes and businesses and passes through mechanically cleaned screens. These remove large objects such as paper, sticks, and rags. The screened wastewater is pumped to large tanks where solid matter either settles, known as biosolids, or floats, otherwise known as scum. The solid matter is separated and removed for further processing and disposal. The remaining liquid flows to aeration tanks where air is bubbled through the wastewater to supply oxygen to microorganisms living in the tanks. These microorganisms use the organic matter and nutrients in the wastewater as food. The wastewater flows to clarifiers where the microorganisms settle as sludge. Most of the biosolids are returned to the aeration tanks to continue the biological process. Any excess of biosolids goes through a process where the water content in it is further reduced, after which it gets incinerated. The final product, inert ash, is hauled by truck to the ashfill at the I-95 sanitary landfill. The remaining biologically treated water is pumped to tertiary clarifiers and filters to remove phosphorus. This is a critical step in reducing nutrients and maintaining water quality in the Chesapeake Bay, the treated water's ultimate destination.